bayad ko, partner. Turning break,
good evening, sir.
Magandang gabi. Abian Alvin at saka Abian Doris. Marinig niyo ba ako?
Yan.
Oo, okay. Mayong gabi.
And I'm very happy to note that you're still on the air despite ABS-CBN's not being on the air anymore. At least you're still in the air. Very happy.
Salamat po. Alam ko niyo si Tony Reyes, isa yung partner sa pagpatikang abogado sa Reyes. Sa Reyes na ito, magpapakang posibilidad sa yan. At yung paglaban. Ano, Atty, muna yung reaction ko ninyo sa resulta ng PNP exam na sinasabi nila, examination na sinasabi nila, walang homicide, walang rape. Christine Dacera died of natural causes, primarily due to aortic aneurysm.
Unang-una, gusto ko lang mapaliwanag na hindi ako yung abogado na humawak ng kaso ni Christine. May tatlong abogado dyan, si Attorney Rojas, Attorney Leda, at saka si Attorney Tulio. Ako naging parang spokesman ng pamilya Dacera dahil sa kilala ko si Christine. At saka nung buhay pa siya, dito sa aming pinagtrabahuan ng kumakain at saka ang kaibigan niya, very close friend, si Dana, was also here with us. So, we were acquaintances. However, para maintindihan ng ating televiewers yung nangyari sa kay Christine, parang just sort of a update on the what happened to her. Unang-una, nung December 31, si Christine pumunta sa City Garden Grand Hotel sa Makati to celebrate the New Year with two other friends, maybe three other friends from the Philippine Airlines. And in the early morning of January 1st, siyempre, Año Nuevo yun, New Year, they were celebrating, may dumating nga iba. All in all, a total of 16 people arrived or were inside room 2209 and 2207 of the Makati City Garden Hotel. 16 men and only one Christine. Okay? Nung mga 8 o'clock, around 8 o'clock in the morning, we believe she already died because of what happened in both rooms, 2207, 2209. Pagkatapos, linipat yung katawan niya sa Makati Medical Center, dito sa Makati rin. And then, subsequently, yung mga police in the Makati City Police Department verified nga may katawan na patay dun sa Makati Medical Center. Then they went back to the hotel and encountered these three individuals, Romel Galido, JP Del Serna, and Mr. De Guzman. And that same afternoon, pumasok liwat sila again, they entered the rooms. In fact, they recovered some evidence and then brought these three gentlemen to the police station. Unang-una, may mali doon because Soko was not informed of the death of Christine and the fact that this room should have been sealed immediately as a possible site for the crime. So, now, Christine's body from the Makati Medical Center is brought to the Rizal Funeral Homes on the evening of January 1st, stayed overnight, was embalmed early in the morning of January 2nd. At around 9 o'clock in the morning, Dr. Sarmiento, who is a police major and a member of SOCO, conducted his medical examination. In other words, the second irregularity here is that the body was embalmed first before it was subjected to medical examination. And findings ni Dr. Sarmiento, na sabi niya, it was ruptured aortic aneurysm, which did not mention at all any of the other injuries sustained by Christine. We have photographs that will confirm these other bodily injuries on her legs, on her hands, even on her back. And we believe that there will be other injuries. There will be other injuries.
Actually, makasagot po ako.
Yes.
Okay. Maano lang, pa-insert lang po dito po. So the point of enumerating the sequential, kumbaga, a turn of events, is ang ina-establish nyo is, procedurally, may mali sa ginawa nila. Therefore, ang resulta ng kanilang findings ay may mali din. Is that what you're saying?
Hindi lang dahil sa sequencing or procedure, but talagang we believe that there is an intent to cover up the cause of the death of Christine Dacera. So, as I was saying...
Ah, sorry, makasabat lang po.
Oo, sige.
Oo po. Kung yan po ang pinupunto ninyo po, Panero, eh, atiman po, ang pamilya Dacera mismo ang nagsusuporta dun sa PNP findings. Sila ho, yung unang investigation, yun po ang kanilang pinangatawanan. At yun pong pinanghawakan ng pamilya na ito ang findings. Now, there's an autopsy report, there's a new finding. Ang tira po natin ngayon ay procedural. Tama po ba, Panero?
That is not correct. Actually, the Dacera family disputed, they questioned the report of Dr. Sarmiento from the very beginning dahil sa mga injuries nga na-sustain ni Christine on her legs, on her arms, at her back were never reported or included in the examination. So that itself is for me not just a procedural problem, it is a... Oh, no, wala. It's not a procedural problem, but it's a factual problem. Why were these injuries overlooked and not included in the medical examination? Okay, so unang-una, dinispute ng pamilya Dacera ang medical examination ni Dr. Sarmiento. Ngayon, lumabas ang ating PNP na may bago namang medico-legal report dated January 11, conducted supposedly by Dr. Palmero of the PNP Crime Lab in Camp Crame. At saka itong report, first of all, let me clarify, this is not a medico-legal examination. This is only a report dated January 11. By that time, nalibing na si Christine sa General Santos on January 10. So January 11, there could not have been any medico-legal examination by Dr. Palmero. Kung tingnan mong mabuti, those who have read the report of Dr. Palmero, you will notice that the date is January 11. Nalibing na yon si Christine sa General Santos, so impossible nga nag-examine siya ng body. Pangalawa, yes.
Yeah, wait lang, Atty. Brick, kasi parang lumalayo po tayo. Ang pinakapuntong ninyo is, in the short of it is, hindi kayo naniniwala na si Christine ay namatay because of natural causes.
That's correct.
Kasi yun po lumalabas ngayon sa report na hindi siya ni-rape, hindi siya pinatay, namatay siya dahil sa natural na mga dahilan, na mga cause.
The Dacera family disputes that. They believe that she was spiked with drugs and sexually molested in either 2207 or 2209. And that contributed to her death. And so...
Pati yung angulong sexually molested, pinaninibigan niyo pa rin.
Yes.
She was sexually assaulted.
That's correct. Because alam ninyo, yung ating batas, anti-rape law, Republic Act 8353, defines rape not only by the use of violence or assault on the female, but it will consider as rape any object that you insert on the private parts of the female, or even if you insert a finger on the private parts of a female, that is now considered as rape. So the medico-legal examination report of Dr. Sarmiento states mayroon abrasion sa private parts of Christine.
May abrasion po, may laceration, pero healed na po.
No. No, the one that is healed is different. If you read closely the medical legal examination, klarong-klaro nga may fresh abrasion. So, we believe that that is sufficient for probable cause for rape. Because yun ang definition ng rape, hindi kailangan ng assault or violence. It only requires an insertion of an object or even a finger into the private parts of the female. So, that is why, pangalawa, pero importante ito maintindihan ng mga nang kumikinig, ngayong medico-legal report ni Dr. Palmero is not a medico-legal examination. Dahil sa yung bangkay ni Christine Dalibing na noong January 11, it was buried on January 10, so there was no way he could examine the body on January 11. And then on page 2 of this medico-legal report of Dr. Palmero, dyan makita mo sa heading niya, opinion lang pala ito. This is an opinion of Dr. Palmero based on the report of Dr. Sarmiento. So it is not a separate medical legal examination. Ang hiningi, ang ginawa ng pamilyang Dacera is they requested for a second autopsy by the NBI, conducted of course on an embalmed body. And this was done by a team of NBI forensic experts. Pumunta sila sa General Santos before the body was buried and examined the body carefully. This is the medico-legal examination that we are waiting for so that we can really have a closer...
You are now banking on the results of the NBI examination. Pero ang problema ngayon dyan, paano yun kung ang NBI, ang resulta ay pabor sa inyong kliyente, sa inyong posisyon, at yung report naman ng PNP ay hindi pabor sa inyong posisyon, ang mangyayari doon?
Alam mo yung ating stage ngayon na Abian Alvin ay preliminary investigation sa Piskalya pa lang. Ang kailangan doon is only probable cause. So kahit na may dalawang medico-legal examination reports that cannot be reconciled, it is now up to the city prosecutor to examine the medico-legal report, determine which is more credible, and if I could underscore the abrasion on the private parts, the fresh abrasion on the private parts of Christine, then we have probable cause for it.
Pero sino ho ang makakapagpatunay that there was rape? Hindi po ba po pwede na may posibilidad din na talagang nakipag-sex siya, consensual, at wala pong naging persahan? So paano ho yan? Without revealing kung ano po yung strategiya ninyo para mapatunayan ito, medyo mahirap, let me understand kung paano kayo nakarating doon sa conclusion na yun, that because of those abrasions, she was raped.
That is already a matter of defense for the respondents. Kasi sa preliminary examination sa Piskalya, hindi yung hinahanap nga guilt beyond reasonable. Ang hinahanap lang, probable cause. Kahit na mayroong counting ebidensya lang to sustain a filing of an information, pwede na yun. Doon na sa korte, during the hearing, magdedepensa yung respondents kung talagang hindi sila nag-participate. Yes, doon na.
Attorney Greg, I'm sorry, but may isa pa po kasi kami. Ang pinaka-importante dito ay...